the Mankon Fondom and Palace. Mankon occupies more than 60% of the Bamenda metropolitan city. The Fondom is endowed with tremendous tourist potentials, amongst them the Mankon Palace, that houses the famous Mankon Museum and the amazing traditional structure, Atum. This is complemented with fascinating cultural festivals, colorful traditional dances, and above all, a generally friendly population. The palace is indeed a veritable destination for the vast rich Mankon Sacred Forest close to the palace, and the enticing beautiful landscape offers fantastic opportunities. Let's move into the palace for a tip of the iceberg. In the heart of the palace, with the paramount throne of Mankon, His Majesty for Ngwafo III. Your Majesty, we are right in front of a structure with an amazing and unique traditional architectural design. I can see an inscription on it, Atum. We may get a brief history of this structure from Your Majesty.
Well, Atum is the main traditional architectural building, the shrine of the Mankon people. It is the oldest building in the palace. It has received several renovations, but still remains the same. Other buildings have changed with modern evolution of building. And we are at Fozan, one of the settlement sites of the Mankon people. Mankon people were at Fumjo when Fomokong selected this site. Unfortunately, his father, who first came to this place, did not live to build the Atum. So Fomokong built this Atum. And it has remained what it was from the foundation, the roof, receiving occasional maintenance. Unfortunately for us too, by 1891, in the confrontation between the Zingraf attack on Mankon, Atum was burnt, and it has been rebuilt. Since it was rebuilt, it remains intact. That was January 1891.
Yeah, Your Majesty, can visitors come right in here to have a full view of this structure or even take photographs?
Yes, no offense. That is why you are taking this picture. If it was forbidden, you wouldn't have been here to take the picture you're taking now.
Yeah, thank you, Your Majesty.
Thank you.
Sangto, one of the courtyards in the Mankon Palace. Your Majesty, as one of the most enlightened and experienced traditional ruler in Cameroon, what are you and your people doing to promote tourism in Mankon Fondom and even beyond?
Well, in our present age, tourism is one of the best industries we have, and the world over. And Cameroon is participating in projecting its touristic sites. Mankon is such a touristic attraction that we have not relented our efforts in cooperating with the touristic activities of government to project some of our sites. This throne here, where I am, is to receive of touristic importance in the field and around the palace. As you go around, you will see some of the attractions we have.
Yeah, Your Majesty, do you people encounter any problems in your ongoing efforts towards promoting tourism?
We have no problems. We have the difficulties of improving the touristic sites for the appreciation of the public. You know, tourism is an industry that needs some investment. And to be able to improve the sites, we need money to build the structures, improve the structures. We need people trained to be able to take care of the touristic attractions besides the antifacts we have. And that is why we are cooperating with the government, with the administration, and expecting some subventions to be able to preserve, maintain the antifacts, and even to produce some of our local crafts, which are very good for touristic presentation. So we need personnel trained for the work. We need some pension and money to keep touristic attractions improved. Now we need technical advice and support from the government.
Yeah, right at Santo, one of the courtyards of the Mankon Palace. And around you can see the beautiful flowers, and also the structures are also very colorful. The monument of Fondefu III of Mankon. This monument was constructed in 1984 during the Nkwi Festival. It is in the acknowledgement of the great works that Fondefu did before departing.
It's a first-class palace in the Northwest Province. It is one of the most attractive centers in Bamenda town and in the Northwest Province as a whole.
This is another club presently in another courtyard of the palace. This is Sangdamukong, and you can see the beautiful traditional designs that make up the environment. It's now moving to one of the by some fascinating and colorful traditional dances at Sangdamukong, another courtyard of the palace. In the Mankon Palace, traditional dances are readily available for entertainment of visitors upon request. Oh.
majesty, you can find the first mother called Marco of Manco.
This is a Kongnuoli family group of Muwatuk Mankon.
Yeah. Here present is the Funzong dance group of Ntambeng Mangkon.
It's a very renowned dance group in this fundom, and it's a juju dance. It is the promoter of the Funzong dance group, a very colorful and fascinating dance group in Mankon. We would wish to get from him the background of this dance group.
Well, thank you for giving me the opportunity. This dance group is a traditional dance group in Mankon, based in Kampo, this group came to exist since 1995, when all the cultural dance groups in Mankon were dying off. I decided to revive this, our father's dance group.
Yeah, so can you give us the achievements of this dance group so far?
We have participated in so many national festivals. The last one was the pre-selection was in 1996, December, from Marwa, which we are waiting anxiously. Dealing with the change from the Cameroon government, they will reschedule the date.
So you are representing the Northwest in the Marwa Traditional Dance Festival?
We are going to represent the Northwest,
yeah,
that national festival.
Yeah, yeah, thank you. But when tourists arrive in Mankon, can we actually at any given moment just call you up to come and entertain tourists, and yes, you are available?
We are always available. Our address is in the palace, Mankon Palace. We are always available.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah. We are now at the Monumental Mankon Museum, located at the entrance of Mankon Palace. This magnificent edifice hosts a wealth of well-documented varied antiquities and artistic patrimonies. There are equally enticing souvenirs in the museum shop, including the Mankon Museum catalog and other interesting publications. This museum is being managed by a team of very experienced and welcoming staff. It is open to the public daily from 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. Actually, you can see the monumental structure, and inside here there are wonderful artifacts that you can really have a view, and I think you would very much be interested in all what is inside. In fact, it's really marvelous. Mankon Palace continues. Yeah, this is one of the traditional huts around the museum. And this is the front view of the museum. The museum, there are a good number of rooms there for envisaged projects, like setting up the information and communication center there, internet, and also a community library, and other aspects of interest. Right besides the Mankon Cultural Hall, it's situated just beside the Funds Palace Mankon. In this hall, there are many cultural and recreational activities that take place for the interest of community and for the interest of tourists. And dance groups that usually animate around the palace, and you can see them in a very colorful regalia, and we wish to get from them their impressions and what they think they can offer to the Mankon community as a whole and the tourism world in general.
Wankang is a young group that is based in Tarikon. And this is not the first place we have come, which is our palace. We have been dancing all over. The last few days we were in Yaoundé to install the Minister of Culture and that of Special Duties. And this time around we are in the palace, and the group is really a fascinating group. They are always ready to be present wherever the phone invites them. They are always there.
So can you assure us that at any given moment that tourists are coming to the palace, when once the phone makes the signal or call, say meet us this morning, you will be available?
The group is 200% present wherever the group is invited.
Yeah, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Yeah. If you have a keen eye on ecotourism, then let's move to the Mankon Sacred Forest, located beside the palace.
This vast forest is indeed very rich in biodiversity. Surveys have made available interesting checklists of birds and plant species. Among the over 150 identified bird species are the Bamenda apalis, the African broadbill, the Cameroon olive green bull, and the green toraku. Well-trained guides are available to take tourists around with binoculars for bird watching, forest walks, or mere sightseeing. Conservation work in this forest is being done by His Majesty the Fawn of Mankon in collaboration with a community-based organization, Center for Integrated Rural Development and Environmental Conservation, CEDEN. Yeah, in front of us are some of the beautiful landscapes we can find in Mankon. Yeah, make an impressive and veritable tour to the Mankon Fondom, the treasure home of the Western Grassfield region of Cameroon. I am Tomnifor Richard Fru, Secretary to the Mankon Museum and Tourism Board.
Thank you.